إن الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله بلوغ المرام وإن the book of the Salah we are today in Hadith 250 so we are starting from that Hadith 250 من أدعية التشهد الأخير. We want to go through the du'as of the last tashahud. What do you mean last tashahud? How many tashahuds you do in your salah? Two. One is the last minutes before taslim. Before taslim, you do one tashahud. And that always called tashahud al-akhir, the last tashahud. There's no tashahud after that. And there's one tashahud before that, for the three rak'ahs or four rak'ah salah. Three rak'ah, four rak'ah salah, there is one tashahud. So that tashahud, we mention it, you have to recite At-Tahiyyatu, As-Salamu, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, and As-Salatu ala nabi. That four sentences is required. That four sentences is required. At-tahiyyatu, that four, it's that sentence. Yeah. At-tahiyyatu lillahi wa salawatu wa tayyibat. And then, as-salamu. Yeah. Ala nabi rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. And then, ashadu la ilaha illallah. And then, as-salatu ala masallahu ala muhammad. That four sentences you recite. When it comes to last tashahud, on top of that four, you recite a lot of other du'as. Some of them wajib, you have to recite, and some of them sunnah. You have to differentiate. So inshallah, we go through some of the du'as, inshallah. من أدعية التشهد, some of the du'as of the last tashahud. 250. وعن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قال, قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, إذا تشهد أحدكم, when one of you are in the tashahud, فليستعيذ, he should seek refuge of. That means command. That is command. When command comes, it comes to be wajib. So when there is command, it's wajib. So that means Allah is commanding, Prophet is commanding, it's wajib to recite this dua after you salat ala nabi, the last issue. فليقول فليستعيذ بالله من أربع. He should seek refuge of Allah from four. ويقول, he should say that four, اللهم إني أعوذ بك. Oh Allah, I seek refuge of you from what? من عذاب جهنم. That's the worst. Last one, the worst one, عذاب جهنم. So how we can be safe from عذاب جهنم? Come one step forward. ومن عذاب القبر. If you're safe from عذاب القبر, you'll be safe from عذاب جهنم. Come forward. ومن فتنة المحيا والممات. And the trial of the life and death. Trial in your life. Yeah. And sometimes you, the person can leave the Islam. That's the worst. And then, trial at the death, how your life will end up. Last minute of your life is counted. Last minute of your life is counted. Very important. Yeah. Allah has aqabatana, inshallah. And then, وَمِن شَرِّ فِتْنَةِ الْمَسِيحِ الدَّجَّالِ. Yeah. Shar. Yeah. The evil of Antichrist. You have tried. A lot of people will believe him as Allah and they follow him. So what's left for you if you follow him as Allah? That means you lost your life. You lost your life. That's the worst. So that four, we ask seek of Allah from that four. As long as you finish Allahumma salli ala Muhammadin wa ala Muhammadin, إنك حميد مجيد, and then you have to read this dua. If you don't know, write and then read in your salah. When you practice, you'll keep by heart. It's not four sentences. Allahumma a'udhu bika min adhabi jahannama wa min adhabi al-qabr wa min fitnati al-mahya wal-mamat wa min sharri fitnati al-masih al-dajjal. You see, a lot of people keep by heart some songs. Okay? Yeah. Even children, you see, keep by heart songs. When it comes to the Quran, it's a bit difficult. Why is it shaitan? Shaitan put barrier between you and the Quran. Prophet was advising people, say, Ya Ahlul Quran! Ya Ahlul Quran! Oh, people of the Quran! Yeah. That's the stage Allah gave. People of Quran. If the Quran have nothing in your life, that's your intention. وفي رواية للمسلم إذا فرغ أحدكم من التشهد الأخير. When you finish the four groups of four sentences of the التحيات. التحيات لله, that's a sentence in there. And then السلام, that sentence. And then أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله, that sentence. And then Allahumma salli ala Muhammad, that four groups. After you finish that four groups, that means the first attahiyat have that four groups. Second attahiyat, that four balas, yeah, the du'as, and this first du'a. This du'a, some of the people, some of the scholars, they have seen it wajib. So we want to see this. And Dawusin, and Ibn Abbas, Dawus. Before we go further, we want to see how valuable is that Dawus. Who is that Dawus? Dawus bin Kaysan. His name is Dawus bin Kaysan. Alimul Yemen. He was a scholar of Yemen on that time. On his time, there was no other scholar in Yemen. Only him. He was a scholar of Yemen. Abu Abdurrahman al-Farisi. He came from Persia. ثم اليمني, and then he became يمني. الحافظ كان من أبناء الفرس. He was one of the children of the army of the Furs. The Furs, the Persian, they sent the army to Yemen before the Islam. So that army, his dad or his current dad were in that army. So he born or grew up in Yemen. Islam came in Yemen, he took this, he accepted Islam. Yeah. So he was one of the descendants or children of the army of Persia. That army has been prepared to take over Yemen from Ethiopians. Arahulita Fitolat Uthman radiallahu anhu. He born at the time of Uthman ibn Affan was Khalifa. Or قبل ذلك, a small bit before him. سمع, he learned it from Zayd ibn Thabit, the young Sahab who wrote the Quran. He was writing the Quran, that was the Prophet, and he wrote the Quran, collected the Quran, time of Abu Bakr. Time of Abu Bakr. وعائشة وأبي هريرة وزيد بن أرقم وجابر, all that companions. وصراغ بن مالك وسفان بن أمية وابن عمر وعبد الله بن عمر عمرو ولازم ابن عباس مدة. All these scholars he learned from them, but he stayed long time with Ibn Abbas. He stayed long time with who? With Ibn Abbas. So the most long life or long time he spent with Abdullah ibn Abbas. So he has the fiqh of Abdullah ibn Abbas. He narrated a lot from Abdullah ibn Abbas. When someone narrates something, we see what's his relation to the one who is narrating from. You say, yeah, I have seen him. I spent with him 2 months. I spent with him 10 years. I spent with him 20 years. That's what difference comes. Someone spent with the Sheikh 20 years, and some of them spent 6 months. If they disagree the hadith, we take the hadith of the one who spent 20 years. Without 20 years, he hear it from the Sheikh 10 times, 20 times, 100 times, the same hadith. So it's more accurate than the one who, that's what you, so you say, لازم Ibn Abbas مدتن. If someone comes narrate from Ibn Abbas, different than the way he's narrating Tawus, we take the Tawus view. وَكَانَ مَعْدُودُ He has been counted as في كُبَرَاي أَصْحَابِهِ The great students of Ibn Abbas. وَكَانَ Ibn Abbas يُجِلُّ Tawus. Ibn Abbas used to respect, show respect to Tawus. وَيَأْذَنَ لَهُ He gave him permission to come مع الخواصي with his close circuit people when he's discussing something special he used to bring him in so that means we see how far how Abdullah bin Abbas respected Tawus Al-A'maj narrated عن عبد الملك عن Tawus قال أدركت 50 من أصحاب رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم I have seen on my life Yeah, there were 50 companions I met of the Prophet. Hadith of the Dawawin Islam. And his hadith in the books of Islam. Hujjah means whatever he says, no one talk after him. Don't have any view after him. Hujjah. Farawa Ada an Abbas, an Ibn Abbas, Ibn Abbas said, Inni la adhunnu Tawus. I'm assuming Tawus min Ahl Jannah. He's one of the people of the jeweler. So we have seen how he's implementing what he learned. Qais bin Sa'd, Qais bin Sa'd bin Ubadah, he's in Madani, his father Sa'd bin Ubadah, chief of Khazraj, he said, Who of Fina? He said, Dawus is for among us, as Ibn Sirin fi Ahl Basra, as Muhammad bin Sirin in Basra. عن ابن أبي نجيح قال مجاهد لداوس مجاهد سيد داوس I have seen you praying في الكعبة I had a dream last night and in my dream I have seen you praying at the كعبة والنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم على بابها and the Prophet was standing at the gate of the كعبة يقول لك he says to you أكشف قناعك remove your cover Let the people see you. وَبَيِّنْ قِرَاءَتَكَ And recite loudly. Let the people hear your recitation. That means Tawus he used to hide. He doesn't want others to know him. He doesn't want others to know his recitation. Now you see a lot of people, they show off recitation today. A lot of people, they show their knowledge. Yeah. They have knowledge. But for him, he was hiding. He didn't want the people to know he has knowledge. He didn't want people to know his recites good. وقال تاوس اسكت. Be quiet. Don't tell others. Yeah. لا يسمع هذا منك أحد. Don't let others to hear that prophecy that to me. ثم خير لي. Just say, I assumed. I know him بسطة في الكلام. He was happy with that كلام. يعني فرحا بالمنام. He was happy to hear that dream. But he doesn't want the people to know. If you have one dream, and we are happy, we bring, say, oh, I have seen the Prophet. That means you want to be staged, the people kiss your hand or your feet. That's what you want. So he's hiding, he doesn't want people to know that. Tawus. And the Rajul Khan is here with Tawus. Tawus was walking with someone. For some Qurabun. Yan Abu. He heard it. The man heard the voice of that group. فقال خير. He said, I wish to be good to hear that the voice of the group. فقال تاوس, أي خير عن هذا أو شر. What good or bad it will give us, yeah, the group, yes, voice. Some people are saying, if you hear this, it's good for you. If you hear this, it's bad for you, isn't it? So Tawus asked him, what's the good for this? Tawus became upset. He said, La tashabni, or la tabshma'i. Don't walk with me again. Yeah. Was the person, yeah, he's going to believe Yeah. Fortune tellers. Yeah. It's good for you and it's bad for you. Well known in the Egypt. Yeah. Don't bring soap at home on Wednesdays. If you buy, keep it outside the house. Yes. So that believes. Yeah. It's not part of Islam. So he said, don't come with me, don't walk with me again. You see how he's strong in his belief? Hamdan bin Abi Sufyan qal, I didn't see a scholar, never, yeah? He says, I don't know, as I have seen Dawood. Ask him a question, he say, I don't know. That's more safe for him than to give you wrong fatwa. Yeah? And then you practice that fatwa and he'll be accountable on judgment day. So he say, I don't know. قال حبيب بن أبي ثابت قال يا داوود إذا حدثتك الحديث فأتل بحديث of the prophet فاثبته لك hold me it فلا تسألنا عنه أحد and don't ask anyone else at that hadith. What I tell you is very accurate. How many people of us they tell something and when you check you see that they are lying or they deceiving or they need some or they want to cause a problem between you and the person. They're not true. When someone tells you something, and you believe that's the right, that means that person's respect for that person will increase in your heart. You respect that person more. Yeah. Ibn Mu'in and Abu Zur'a, that's scholars later on, they say Dawood's thika is trustworthy. Tufiya Dawood in Makkah. Dawood, he died in Makkah. Ayam al-Mawasim, the days of Tashriq, Bimina. At the Hajj time, he died in Mina. Yeah. Sana 105. And the people who know him, they say, Rahimallahu Abu Abdurrahman, Allah's mercy upon Abu Abdurrahman. Hajja 40 Hajjatan. He done 40 Hajj. 40 Hajj. Prophet told us, yeah, don't leave the Haram 5 years. Within 5 years, you should go to Hajj. Within 5 years, you should go to Umrah. Yeah. So as much. 40 Hajj, he done. So this is a Tawus. Now we understand who read from Ibn Abbas. Riwayat Muslim. Dawood narrated from Ibn Abbas. Yes. So now, you know Ibn Abbas, and you know Dawood, so you trust that narration. Anna Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam kana yu'allimuhum hadha du'a. Prophet used to teach them this du'a. Used to teach them this du'a. What's the du'a? كَمَا يُعَلِّمُهُمُ السُّورَةِ مِنَ الْقُرْآنِ As he teaches them the surah of the Qur'an. That shows how important is that du'a. يَقُولُ اللَّهُمَّ قُولُوا اللَّهُمَّ And then the du'a. They have to repeat the du'a. But you have seen the du'a. اللَّهُمَّ إِنِّي أَعُوذُ بِكَ من عذاب جهنم ومن عذاب القبر ومن فتنة المحيا والممات ومن شر فتنة المسيح الدجال قال مسلم بن حجاج Who knows that مسلم بن حجاج Who knows Imam Muslim That was his knows If you say Imam Muslim That means we know him yeah. What's his book Sahih Muslim Yes He said بلغني It has been, yes, the news reached me. And Dawood qala ibnihi, Dawood said to his son, Ad'awda bihada fi salatika, did you recite this dua in your salah? Qala la. So, want to see how important that dua is in the view of Dawood. And you know the Dawood who is? So how he looked into that dua? Did you hear that du'a in your salah? The son said no. Yeah. Repeat your salah. Because you miss wajib. They bid you salah. That's what I was saying. Some scholars are saying it's sunnah, not required. And all madhab is saying that du'as after tashahud, it's not, you can leave it. Look, Tawus, how it's emphasizing. You read that du'a? No, repeat your salah. One is, this was a proposal for marriage to someone. And then he was going to the family. So, Tawus have seen his son, yeah, oiled his hair and combed his hair up more than the ordinary way. Yeah. Once you have seen him say, sit, don't go. That means you are giving different impression to the people. Yeah. When you don't have khamis and you don't pray at all, or you don't have praying, I want God to propose buy new khamis and new imam and show that you are good, that's cheating. That's cheating. The people do that, but that's cheating. Yeah. Let people see you as you are. Yeah, in your life. And then they can decide whether you accept you or not. لَأَنَا تَعُوُسَ رَوَاهُ عَنْ ثَلَاثَةٍ أَوْ أَرْبَعَةٍ But Tawus narrate from 3 and 4 different narrations in that, how important is that dua. So now we understand how important that dua. We stop here, inshallah. سُحَانَكَ رَبَّ حَمْدُكَ أَشْهَدُ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا أَنْتَ أَسْتَغْفِرُكَ وَأَتُوبُ إِلَيْكَ وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين